Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to be talking about the Macy's affiliate program. So be sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell if this video or any other video on this channel helps you out in any way. So what we're going to do today is we're going to talk about the good and the bad of the Macy's affiliate program, and I'm going to answer the question, should you jump aboard? Now, this video is in association, in addition to this blog post. You can go over to AustinGodbolt.com to learn more in depth about the Macy's affiliate program. In fact, I'll include a link in the description to this blog post so that you can learn about it more in depth. Now, if you're not familiar, Macy's is a department store. It used to be a mainstay. It used to be this major department store. Now, like everything else, it's shifted to online. They've closed a bunch of stores, but they still have a pretty strong foothold in the industry, but mostly you're going to find it online. They have all sorts of products to promote for men, women, babies, and we'll talk about that in just a moment. But let's go ahead and talk about some important things. Let's talk about the affiliate program, how you can get started, the commission, the cookie duration, all the things that you want to know so that you can decide if you want to make money. Now, you can actually get signed up with Rakuten. Now, the interesting thing is I learned how to say that word because now that I'm looking at Rakuten, and I'm looking at these different affiliate programs, I'm now seeing ads for Rakuten everywhere. I'm watching Hulu, I see these ads. I'm watching, you know, YouTube videos, I'm seeing these ads now. So they're going to make sure that I understand how to say it, and I still butchered it. Anyway, you can join it with, as I mentioned, Rakuten. That's an affiliate network that has thousands of different affiliate programs. They're the intermediary between the affiliate marketer and the actual affiliate program, or the company, in this case, Macy's. Now, the interesting thing is I personally feel like having a affiliate network adds an additional layer of complexity, because before you can even apply for the Macy's affiliate program, you have to be approved and accepted into the affiliate network. And usually what happens is both the affiliate network and the affiliate programs are going to ask you basically the same things when it comes to enrolling in the affiliate network or program. But the good thing is the flip side to it is if you work with an affiliate network that's a mainstay, like Rakuten, you can apply to multiple affiliate programs, and everything's in one place. It's very easy. Right now, let's say you are an affiliate for Bluehost and then HostGator, you've got to go to two different websites. But at least the positive is everything is in one spot, and so it makes it kind of easy to figure out one dashboard and all that good stuff. Now, with that being said, let's go ahead and talk about the commission structure as well as the cookie window. If we scroll up here, the cookie window is 10 days, I believe. Let me just make sure. Yep, 10-day cookie window, and then they actually will pay you a 3% commission, which is a little low, but that's to be expected when it comes to promoting physical products. As I've mentioned a few different times on this blog and website, when you're promoting physical products, there's so much more overhead and the margins are much lower that they really will clamp down on the amount of money that they'll pay affiliate. So the good news is the 10-day cookie window is very nice. If you're looking to compare with Amazon, which is everybody's competitor, they only have a 24-hour cookie window. So after 24 hours, the cookies expire. And then in contrast, Macy's actually has a 10-day cookie window. So that's a good thing. The commission's 3%. It's probably going to be a little bit lower. It's going to be on par or a little bit lower than Amazon. It's also probably lower than some of the other retail affiliate programs in the space. For example, I think Gap pays a little bit more. I'll talk about that in a separate video, but let's talk about some good things about this program. The good thing, in my opinion, is there is a lot of products to choose from. Again, you can promote men, you can promote women, you can promote babies. The good thing with promoting babies is it's an evergreen niche. People are always going to buy a bunch of stuff that they may or may not need for babies. In fact, they just threw out a changing table that we use like 5 times. Side note, if you have kids, if you plan on having kids, 90% of the stuff that you buy, you're not going to use. Changing table, most often you're just going to change the kid on the floor. Anyway, if we're continuing on, lots of opportunity. You can create blog posts, you can create YouTube, you can be very niched down. And even if you look at Macy's website, let me just bring that up for you real quick. We'll go to Macy's. I think I spelled that wrong. Macy's. We'll go over to Macy's website and you'll see there is tons of opportunity. You could just focus on dress shoes or just focus on school wear, back to school, summer, gifts for dad, as you can see, Father's Day. There's so many different ways that you could potentially earn money with this affiliate program. You just have to pick a niche and stay. Oftentimes we get a little bit antsy because it's not breaking for us right away. But as you can see here, we've got men's, women's, kids, shoes, jewelry, handbags, home, bed and bath, kitchen, a lot of opportunity. I like promoting kitchen stuff again, because that's going to be evergreen. And usually this stuff is kind of pricey. This George Foreman grill here is $162. If you got 3% of that, you would need to make a few sales to make that up, but it's an opportunity to do that. $149 for some knives here, but you can see there's some opportunity. $186 for container set, $166, excuse me. But as you can see, there is opportunity here in a variety of ways. You could start three different blogging sites or YouTube channels and focus on just men and then women and then kitchen and bath, and use the Macy's affiliate program to promote all of them. Everything is in one spot. So I really like that. I'm not a huge fan of the lower commission. 3% is pretty low. If you wanted to promote, there are kitchen, like KitchenAid has their own affiliate program. You could potentially make money, more money with that affiliate program. But as I mentioned, this could be a good opportunity because there's a lot of opportunity within Macy's. You just need to pick a niche. I think the hardest thing that you would have to do when it comes to promoting the Macy's affiliate program is picking one niche and then staying there. As you can see here, the opportunities that I list: women's apparel, men's apparel, kids and baby clothes, shoes for all, handbags and accessories, jewelry. There's a lot of opportunity there. Watches as well. So again, you could find success with this affiliate program as long as you pick a niche, stay there, and create helpful content. Now, the most important thing that you should do when you're creating content is create content based on what the customer wants to know and not necessarily what you want to tell them. For example, you want to look up how-to videos. You want to maybe do try-on hauls because people want to see how it fits. They want to see how it looks. Don't create a channel where you're just telling people what to do. You're not going to have a good time, and it's going to be difficult to find viewers and get subscribers. So hopefully this helped you out. Overall, I do like the Macy's affiliate program. I don't like the 3% commission. I would like it at like 20%, but we know with low margins, that's just not going to be possible. And when I say low margins, we're thinking about the cost to store these physical products, the cost to maintain a physical store. For example, there used to be a Macy's in Gurnee Mills over here, and you have to have employees, you have to have security, you have to pay to have the lights on, you have to pay for internet, all of that stuff where we may not think about, that all factors into the amount of money that they're willing to pay affiliates. So hopefully this helps you out. Be sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell. Check out this blog post if you want more in-depth information about the Macy's affiliate program. So that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.